We now come to the evening's penultimate award, which is for Political Book of the Year. The winner of this award is also going to be a recipient of a £10,000 prize, generously donated again by Lord Ashcroft. Thank you very much indeed. And the judges all got together, I'm going to tell you who they were, they all got together for this prize, and they had a wonderful working lunch, but it was very tasty and delicious at Westminster's newest political hotspot, the Intercontinental Hotel. You know, they do the Intercontinental, they have lunch and they choose who the winner should be. So let me tell you who the judges were. We took our cameras there.
Lord Ashcroft, international businessman and Tory peer. Classicist Mary Beard. Adam Bolton, political editor of Sky News. Former Labour MP and best-selling diarist Chris Mullin. Presenter of Radio 4's Westminster Hour, Caroline Quinn. And Total Politics books editor Keith Simpson MP.
Here to present the award for Political Book of the Year, would you please give a warm, very warm welcome to our friend, benefactor, it's Lord Ashcroft.
Thank you, Giles. You've been surprisingly impressive this evening. Owen Jones, who very kindly said that his prize that I was donating, he would give to causes. I would like to have a chat with you, Owen, because between us, I'm very happy to pay these to charities of your choice for a number of reasons. One, I'll get tax relief. Two, they can get gift aid, which will give them a little bit more. Thirdly, you won't have to pay any tax on the prize.
Excellent.
Therefore, if I could invite you to lunch at my local greasy spoon, the House of Lords, to discuss that, I would be delighted.
Well done.
And it is, of course, an enormous privilege for me to be here in such distinguished company this evening and to help champion excellence across all areas of political publishing. I think it's long overdue that the brilliant work of our political authors was more widely acclaimed. And I'm delighted to have played a small part in supporting the launch of the Paddy Power and Total Politics Book Awards. And I am confident that after the undoubted success of this evening, it will become a prestigious annual event in the publishing calendar. And I'd like to thank our accomplished panels of judges. I know they share my belief that the standard of entries has been breathtakingly high. And this has had the knock-on effect of making the judges' task of singling out a winner of each category so much more difficult. All the authors nominated for their work deserve credit for combining the hard graft, dedication, and raw talent that are needed to produce a book of merit. And I'd like to thank Ian Dale, the publisher of Total Politics, for coming up with the idea for tonight's awards. And I'm hugely grateful to Patrick Kennedy, the CEO of Paddy Power, for his firm's generous co-sponsorship. And another plug for you, Mr. Kennedy, is anybody in the audience believes that there will be a Conservative majority at the next election, you may quadruple your money at Paddy Power with odds of 3-1 on that outcome. Thank you, too, for the many others who have worked tirelessly to make this evening possible. I have no doubt that in the years ahead, these awards will encourage new authors and reinvigorate veteran authors by celebrating and rewarding their literary skills. And my final task this evening is to say that the nominees for the Political Book of the Year are...
The Burden of Power by Alastair Campbell, published by Hutchinson. Why Nations Fail by Daron Ace McGlew and James A. Robinson, published by Profile Books. Education, Education, Education by Andrew Adonis, published by Biteback Publishing. Ever the Diplomat by Sherrod Cowper Coles, published by Harper Press. Britain's Quest for a Role by David Hannay, published by I.B. Torres. The Politics of Coalition by Robert Hazel and Ben Young, published by Hart Publishing. A History of the World by Andrew Marr, published by Macmillan. Live from Downing Street by Nick Robinson, published by Bantam Press. Everybody Matters by Mary Robinson, published by Hodder and Stoughton. The Day Parliament Burnt Down by Caroline Shenton, published by Oxford University Press.
And the winner is Caroline Shenton, The Day Parliament Burnt Down.
Bravo! Caroline Shenton. Congratulations. Come and speak to your people.
Well, that is completely unexpected. Thank you very much to everybody. I'd like to particularly thank my agent, Bill Hamilton, who I think is probably getting a bit fed up of going to awards since he is the agent also for Hilary Mantel. And also to the fantastic team at OUP Trade. Parliament's had a bad time recently, probably not quite as bad as it was in 1834. But my book is really a fairly heavily disguised description of change in Parliament. And I think that the more that people understand about Parliament, the more that they'll come to value it, and then the more that they will feel part of it once again. So thank you all very much. And I'm very sorry that Chance the Fire Dog couldn't be here tonight to accept with me.
Well done. Congratulations. Thank you, Lord Ashcroft. Isn't it wonderful to be the author of the political book of the year?